In this video, we're going to be reviewing the MET1000 electrical tester from Megger. Now, the key thing that we want to emphasize, first of all, is that this MET1000 is not a multimeter. It will measure voltage, resistance and current, and even carry out phase rotation tests, but it is absolutely not a multimeter. It is an electrical tester. It even says it on there, you see, electrical tester, not a multimeter. Why am I laboring this point? Because of this direction in GS38, which is a guidance note on electrical test equipment for use on low voltage electrical systems published by the HSE. It states, where a test is being made simply to establish the presence or absence of voltage, a proprietary test lamp or two-pole voltage detector suitable for the working voltage of the system should be used rather than a multimeter. The use of incorrectly set multimeters or makeshift devices for voltage detection has often caused accidents. So this is not a multimeter, it is primarily a voltage indicator and complies with all the relevant requirements for a voltage indicator that is used to prove safe isolation. From the things you may not normally think about, like the fact that it not only complies with BSEN 61243-3, but also has that information as well as all the voltage categories it can be used on permanently embossed into its surface. You may have already noticed that this tester requires two AAA batteries to operate correctly. However, even if we remove the batteries, as you can see here, it will still operate as a voltage indicator and can still be used to prove safe isolation. More on just how it complies with GS38 in a moment. First, let's discuss the additional functions it can carry out. Now, most voltage indicators will give you an idea of the band of voltage that the tested electricity falls within, but won't give you an accurate reading to the volt. However, we're already starting to see this is not your typical voltage indicator, and it can be used to measure voltage right down to 0.1 volts, perfect for checking the voltage in, say, an EV charger that seems to be tripping off for no good reason. It will also measure resistance from 1 ohm up to 50 kilo ohms. This is achieved simply by pressing the button here until you get an Omega symbol down here in the bottom corner, and then you can use it to measure the resistance of components. As well as specific measurements of resistance, it can also be used as a continuity tester. If the meter hasn't been triggered, simply connecting the probes together will place it in this mode, and it can then be used for the usual purposes such as tracing conductors when your colleague has forgotten to mark the ends of the cables up. And if you've pressed this button and set the mode it's in, then you can return to continuity mode by a long press on this button. And just to complete the triumvirate of AVO testing, it can also be used for measuring current by using this forked section at the front here. For this test, you must remove the leads from the sockets on the base of the tester, and then it's simply a matter again of pressing this button until you've got an A down in this bottom corner of the screen, and then position it so the conductor to be measured sits in the base of here. So you can see here, this conductor has between 29 and 30 amps running through it, and it will measure up to 200 amps. Notice though, that as with all clamp type meters, it's important not to put the line and neutral in there, as they'll cancel each other out and you'll read zero current. The exception of course being if you're testing for earth leakage current. Check out the video we made on how to do that by clicking the link above my head. The MET1000, however, has some features that makes it stand out in the crowd, such as a single pole phase check, where you remove one probe for safety and then use the remaining probe on a terminal, and if the circuit is live, it will sound and flash when connected to the line terminal and remain silent when connected to the neutral. And you can even use it to carry out a phase rotation test on a three-phase circuit. Speaking of the probes, if we look at the tips on here for a moment, you can see that there's a couple of different options that we can connect to them. There's these ones that have a lot of metal exposed, and these are perfectly acceptable for use when you're using the meter to test resistance and bell out circuits, and also for connecting to 4mm test sockets. But if we unscrew them, then we get these pointed probes left behind, and then screwing the other accessories provided onto the ends of these, we get a tip where only 2mm is exposed, and that then complies with GS38 for making connections and testing to live terminals. The tester also has these moulded holders that the probes sit in and can either be used to test in this position or one held in place and the other free to move around, or of course both can be detached and used freely for contacting awkward to reach terminals. And I don't know about you, but I'm a nightmare for losing essential little bits and bobs like this. Unfortunately, the MET1000 comes with a little holder that sits on the test lead here, and there's a port to contain each of the lead accessories. So the blanks sit in here, the 4mm tips go in here, and the GS38 tips live in this section here. Another couple of features that we absolutely love about this tester include the fact that the leads are replaceable, which means that should these ever become damaged in any way, you can replace just the leads, not the entire unit. Another feature is that it comes with a belt carrier as standard, so you don't have to pay any extra for that, which is fantastic. And of course, earlier in the video, we saw this tester being used outside in the rain, and it's perfectly suitable for that because it's rated at IP65, meaning that it can be used both inside and outside in slightly wet conditions. And finally, if you hold this button here down for 2 seconds, there's a torch in the end here that illuminates for the less than perfect testing situations that we find ourselves in from time to time. So there we go. This is a great electrical tester that can be used for measuring various electrical values and also be used as part of a safe isolation procedure to prove dead. But as always, we want to hear from you. What do you make of this electrical tester? Will it be on your wish list when it comes to your next voltage indicator? Are you carrying out rigorous safe isolation as part of your day-to-day work? Whatever your thoughts and questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.